因为即系人已经好啦嘛。
Because this person is already well. He can already walk. Why did Jesus have to say, pick up your mat? This particular statement seems superfluous. May I say this again? Not a single statement of God is superfluous. Every word of God carries with it a lot of truth. So what does this phrase, pick up your mat, mean? There are two important messages here.
Number one, do they imagination?
Imagine.
What's that? This is mat, not imagination.
Imagine that's a mat.
This
person has been on the mat
and
has been doing so for
38 years.
Within the span of 38
years, 请问, may I ask?
So,
who needs what?
Is it the case that the mat needs the invalid or the invalid needs the mat?
Of course.
Definitely, the invalid needs the mat.
Because this mat is the person.
Because this mat has been carrying this person, the weight of this person
for so many years.
And 38 years ago, 38 years ago, this person needs the mat. This mat has been carrying this invalid for 38 years. Jesus said, get up, pick up your mat. This time, you will see who needs who. Now, earlier, it was a mat carrying the person. Now, it's the person carrying the mat. So, may I ask you, who needs who? It looks like the mat needs the person.
Take up your mat.
That's why Jesus said, take up your mat. It means first he was completely healed. You don't need the mat anymore. The mat needs you, however. This problem is resolved. Before this problem overcame you, overwhelmed you. Now you actually are able to conquer the problem. This time you're fully well. Now you have the capability. You are now able to bear this problem. This time the problem actually, this matter actually needs you. You're healed. You don't need it anymore. Second,
because
before it was he who needed the mat, now it's the mat which needs him. Even so, here comes another problem. If I don't pick up this mat, there could be a second problem that would ensue. He would continue to lie down.
So
it's just like saying you're not only well, but you're not supposed to continue lying down on the mat. Notice. For 38 years, the person has been so used to that mat. His life is inseparable from the mat. That's 38 years of being of habitual actions lying on the mat. We are all creatures of habits. Good habits are of course will do you good. Bad habits can do you lots of harm. Lying down on the mat, that's definitely a sign of bad. Right. So don't continue lying down. So that you won't go back to the same old
path.
If you have a problem, you probably would still go back to that man. We are all like that.
Keep the people.
Those people who are drug users. Even if they have already fully rehabilitated themselves. However, in case of problems,
temptation,
when they're tempted,
你想想,
what would they do?
你要不到期,
they would go back to 你要不到期, the same old spot. Because that's his habit. That's where his mat was.
你那么完全改过的,
unless you solve that mat of habit problem,
你得到不到期,
you would definitely go back to that habit of mat.
你知道吗?
brothers and sisters.
那家裡有什麼東西啊?
What are things in your house that are not supposed to be there?
現在你說,
then you keep on saying, no, I want to look at it anymore. I've truly repented. Then burn them.
那不是,
if not,
等你軟弱的時候,
when you're weak,
你重新都来跨,
you would go back to the spot. It's always like that.
你哪位家的老子条路,
as long as you have that way still open to you,
你这个都可以,
you will definitely turn back.
人都是安妮,
human beings are like that.
我自己的经验,
I have this experience.
1988,
when I came to the Philippines, I met this young man. I have known him for 3 years.
后来我们去,
I left that original church to come to CBCP. I've never met the person again.
14-15
years later, he came to see me.
也在那时候,
when he came over,
我看到他,
I saw he was in a deplorable state.
他说他很困难,
he told me how many, actually he has so many problems.
叫我到沙岗,
and he wanted me to help him.
我当然帮助你,
but of course, I'm more than willing.
Because
I've known him
before.
I've known him since I came from Hong Kong, so I helped him.
我来无罗姑,
then after some time, he came back again.
Asked for something to help.
And then he asked for help again.
我帮助你,
and I gave him some help again.
但是后来,
I sent something wrong with this person.
跟来特别来查过,
how come he's always in need?
我卡好这个人的阿妈, grandma.
I called up the grandmother of this particular young man.
检查他不知道我毕业的 grandma,
maybe he doesn't know that I know his grandmother. I talked to the grandmother. I told the grandmother about his coming
to
visit. The grandmother was furious.
He
said, pastor, don't help him. He was just fooling you. Then I realized then he actually did something wrong. He's a drug user. He stole money from people. He has been a compulsive
sinner.
So the family members drove him away.
啊,
and that's the case.
这个礼拜一个来车过,
after 1 week, he popped up again. This time, I was unhesitant. You actually fooled me. I actually talked to your grandmother. He was aghast. Then he started crying.
我说你若没悔改过来骗我你不能过来,
if you don't want, if you are insistent on not repenting, don't come and see me again.
Okay.
Then you go back home.
差不多几个月以后,
after a few months
他过来找我,
he came back again.
好了,
at this time he's in tears.
他说他要重新开始,
he said he's remorseful, he's going to start his life again.
他说他要路没走,
he knows that it's a dead end now. Now he's turning back.
你帮助我,
help me. And I helped him. I had this plan. I sent him to a rehabilitation center. I paid for 1 year expenses in that rehabilitation center. I sent the money to the rehab center. I told one pastor to help me take care of this. And this pastor is in constant communication.
Very good.
And he said it's very good, he's doing well.
有汤吃, 有汤困, 过来追工,
there's shelter, there's food, there's work within that rehab center. And then a little pocket money.
He's doing very good.
And this young man has been doing well.
真,
I was gratified.
After almost 1 year.
After 1 year, I told the pastor, I will send the money for the second year, payment for the second year.
Pastor, hold it.
Then the person said, let's hold it. Why? Because he already left the rehab center. He find it too tiresome to be there. So he left.
结果三礼拜以后,
3 weeks later,
他过来找我了,
he popped up again.
我说你个头走,
and why did you left the rehab center?
他说很多很多故事,
then he told me lots of stories.
又好啊,
then he was in tear again. This time I'm not giving him money.
哦,一淡薄沙,淡薄力家,淡薄生活,
I gave him some clothing and some daily necessities.
你先讲过来, 卡去, 斜, 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 我撒不耶冷,
and then I called up to a common friend, called up a common friend. And I realized,
如果牧师说,
and I got to know from that common friend that he's back to his old ways.
He is now a
drug user again. He is now back on the dead end street. Unless you are resolute,
那有机会,
if you have a chance,
咱就不倒去,
you'll definitely still go back.
所以才要跟他说说, get up, pick up your mat.
That's why you realize why Jesus said, pick up, get up your mat.
你不是自己起来,
you not only stand up,
你的后路都站起来,
you must sever the tie with the mat.
那不是,
if not,
到这个时间,
there will come a time where we'll go back and lie on that same old mat. Because there's 38 years of being habituated, that's his habit. May God help us. The third statement of Jesus. When Jesus met this man again, Jesus told him, you're well again, stop sinning or something worse may happen to you. This is a warning. This is a warning of love.
为什么呢?
Why?
这警告里面无论行大事,
there are two things in this warning of love.
要说说,
Jesus is trying to tell him your sickness resulted from sin.
哎呀,
let's not overgeneralize.
因为不是当中的病,
because not all sins emanate from sins. Not all sickness emanate from sin.
这个灵魂派的教会常常说,
but there are certain charismatic groups which always insist that you are sick because you committed a crime. Don't need to go to a doctor. You just pray and acknowledge your sin. I feel this is an oversimplification. There are certain kinds of sickness that ensued from sin, but not all. If you read John chapter
9,
there's another miracle stated there. Jesus healed someone who had been blind since birth. Jesus said, this person, he's not blind because of sin. His blindness is in order for Jesus to manifest the glory of God. That's why, then let's not overgeneralize. But in the case of this man, Jesus categorically said,
stop sinning.
Stop sinning. Don't sin anymore. In this case, this man's sickness is a result of sin. We don't know what kind of sin he has committed. That he had been sick for 38 years. But Jesus said, I'm telling you, Jesus said, your sickness is because of your sin. Sin no more. May God help us. If we are sick, don't rush to the doctor first. First thing, you don't see a doctor, you see God first. You examine yourself in the face of God. What's the cause of
this?
If it's because of my sin, of transgression,
yeah,
I did something that made God very unhappy. Before you go and see a doctor, you go and see God to confess your sin. After confession, then you go and see a doctor. So notice the procedure. You see God first, then you see the doctor second. And not the other way around. Why? When you see God, the Lord has a power and grace to forgive sins. He can forgive our sins. He can heal our sicknesses. That's what David said in Psalm 103. That's why King David thanked God that God pardoned all his sin and cured all his sicknesses. Second, sin no more. So that something worse won't happen to you. Don't sin anymore. Something worse may happen to you. In John chapter 8, there was this incident. This woman was guilty of adultery, was caught by people. You're so familiar with that story. Then a lot of people said, should we stone her? Should we kill her? And Jesus replied, those of you who are without sin, then you pick up the first stone and cast it. And then everybody fled. Only two persons are on scene. This adulterous woman and Jesus. Jesus didn't leave. Because only Jesus is qualified to cast the first stone. But Jesus said, I will no longer condemn you, but sin no more. May God help us. Jesus forgives our sins. That's grace. But don't abuse the grace. There would come a time this sin could get worse. Don't continue to indulge yourself in sin. There are habitual sins in our lives. You commit it time and again, so and so. So it's an endless cycle of commitment and confession.
No.
It shouldn't be the case.
I'm sorry to tell you.
I'm sorry to tell you, yes. That's a problem with Catholicism. After you sin, you go and see a confessor. After confession, you're then you go back to sin. Then you confess again. Then you
No.
Don't indulge in endless cycles. The Bible wasn't telling us that.
Sin no more.
Sin no more, that's what it says. Do not sin anymore, that's what it says. So that something worse may happen to you. 38 years he was there on the mountain. Could there be something worse than that? It could be. Probably not 38 years. Probably 380 or 3,800 years. Or 38,000 years. 380,000 years. 3,800,000 years. It could happen. That's eternity. Because if you don't confess your sin at this point, the body won't get healed.
If
you continue to sin, the sin's problems are solved. There are only two paths for you in the future.
Forever perish and forever have eternal life.
It's either you have eternal life or you perish forever.
Otherwise, forever and ever.
From this, in the realm of future, it's all eternity. Isn't that worse?
Yes,
that's so.
So, make
God help us.
After
Jesus cured and healed this person, then Jesus said, sin no more. If the person actually followed what Jesus said, not only will he be physically well, his spiritual life will definitely be healed.
His whole body, holistic,
this is body, soul, and spirit all healed. May God help us. First statement. Do you want to get well? This is a statement that gives hope to the hopeless. If you are hopeless, if you feel hopeless for everything, you need to ignite that ember of hope.
Do you want to get well?
Do you want to get well? Jesus
said.
Jesus always give people hope.
起来,
pick up your mat and walk. Lord's healing is complete. But man must do his part and never turn back. The previous path is a dead end street.
I have decided to follow Jesus.
That's why the song goes.
Turning back.
That's why the song goes, I've decided to follow Jesus and no turning back. I'm not turning back. Third statement. See, you're well again. Stop sinning. Or something worse may happen to you. Grace of God is of course good. But we just love the grace but don't love the giver of grace. Then we will definitely sin again.
所以耶稣讲唔得个犯罪咯。
That's why Jesus said, "Don't sin anymore."
免得更加严重。
So that nothing worse will happen to you.
基督帮助人。
May God help us.
望人得到这上帝三句话嘅教导。
May we learn the lesson of these three statements.